We discussed now. So in other databases like Excel and all, we used to have data in a dump, raw dump kind of a thing, where all the data
is raw dump
in one particular sheet, where it is not properly organized. Okay.
Yes.
So such that to retrieve the data, it is little difficult to retrieve the data or manage the data, manipulate the data. Everything becomes a little difficult if you have unorganized data present in only single table. Okay. Now, if you generally to start with creating tables in database, while creating the tables itself, we'll have to keep in mind some set of steps such that you can.
Your voice is breaking, sir.
My voice is breaking. Now it's fine.
Yes, sir, too much. Yes, sir.
Okay. So I was just telling, when you are creating tables in databases, what we generally do is we'll have to create in such a way that we will follow some procedures defined by Microsoft or followed by some standards has been created for all the databases. Actually, it's not only by Microsoft. It is a standard which has to be followed while creating tables in databases. Okay. So that particular concept is called normalization. So if you follow these normalization techniques, then your data is properly organized and you can connect your data in such a way that you can easily retrieve your data accordingly. Right. So that's what normalization is all about. Okay. So we'll just see. There are basically three normalization forms. Okay.
Okay.
First normalization, second normalization, third normalization form. So three normalization forms available in SQL Server. Now we'll see what are those normalization concepts, how we will work it out on that. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. What is normalization? First of all, we'll first understand what is normalization. Okay. Unnormalized data. That's what I'm saying. Organized or normalized. Both are, you can consider both are same. Okay, so unnormalized or unorganized data exists in flat files. Flat files in the sense, probably text files or Excel files, all that. Okay, so normalization is a process of moving data into organized set of tables or related tables. This is usually done by running queries, make table, append query. Unless you are starting from the scratch, then you are doing it from the, generally we do it from the scratch. Now, whatever we are creating tables, we'll do it from the scratch. So we are going to follow the normalization techniques. Okay. So what is the advantages of normalization? Okay. That's first advantage, saving the typing of repetitive data. Okay. Now I will give you one example. Let's say I have employee name, employee ID, employee name, department name, and employee related information is there. Okay. Now that is a raw dump we have. Now normalization refers to splitting the department table into a separate table. Okay. We'll see those rules and regulations, how we spread that. Okay. Now there what we do, instead of specifying the department name every time, let's say admin department, HR department, IT department, there we keep repeating every time. No? So we can avoid repetition in the same table, and we can keep that in a different table. That's what saving typing of repetitive data means. Maybe if you see practically one data, if you see, you'll understand it better. But it saves the typing of repetitive data again and again. Okay. The second advantage is increase the flexibility to query, sort, summarize, and group data. Very easy to manipulate the data. Okay. So as we already discussed, if you have data in multiple...
selling the voice, it's cracking.
Hello,
one second. Let me re-log in again, probably some network issue.
Yes.
Okay, I'll disconnect and connect again. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hello.
Yes, sir.
None of it's fine?
Yes.
Yeah, probably some network related issues. That's okay. Okay, fine. So I was just discussing about the advantages of normalizing your tables. One is to save typing of repetitive data. That means I can avoid repetition of entering the same set of data again.
Okay.
And that's
okay.
One thing. And second thing is increase flexibility to query, sort, summarize, and group data. Okay. Now, if you have data distributed across multiple tables, it is very easy to query a particular table and get that data in a very easy way, in a faster way. Okay, such that performance related issues will also not be there. So it is easy to manipulate data. It is easy to retrieve data as well. Okay, so that's what it says. So obviously flexibility also will get increases. Okay, and the third thing is avoid frequent restructuring of tables and other objects to accommodate new data. Okay, now if at all, if your data is structured in a proper way, and if you're trying to enter some set of information, you can only enter information in that particular table without disturbing other tables as such. Okay,
okay.
Such that you need not bother other parameters, only whatever you want to enter, you can enter in that specific table. Other tables will not get disturbed as such. That's what avoid frequent restructuring of tables, because if you're only inserting data in one table, the other tables will not get disturbed. So you need not restructure as such. Everything are already connected. So no need of restructuring again.
Okay. Only wherever I want, I can do the changes.
Right. In whichever information, let's say I have employee table, I have department table, I have salary table, three tables are there. Now let's say if somebody's salary is increased or decreased or whatever, it modified, then you can go and modify the salary table only.
Okay.
You need not disturb the employee table. You need not disturb the department table. Only salary can be updated. So that's the advantage of having the multiple tables as such.
Okay.
Okay. Then the last point says reduce disk space. Okay. So as I mentioned, you need not again and again increase the number of records in all the tables. You are only updating in one table. Obviously, the disk space also can be reduced. Okay.
Okay.
So, when you see a practical example, you will get a more clarity on what it is. Okay. So let's go and see one example. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So this is how a typical spreadsheet file looks like. Okay. There, every data is repetitive. Okay, and every data doesn't follow our normalization standards. It is very much a raw dump kind of a data. Okay. If you observe here, employee number 10, employee name, which is Thomas. Again, Thomas is getting repeated multiple times. Employee number is also repeating multiple times.
Okay.
There is something called time card number, which is again, there are multiple records. 106 is getting repeated again. Okay,
yes,
and time card slot date, some date is there, date is also repeating, and there are some null values for your employee number 99.
Correct.
Values are there, and department number is also repeating, department name is also repeating. So this is a very very plain raw data where there is lot of redundant data, that is repeated data available in same columns. Okay, so this is not the way how you construct your database. Actually, when you're creating a table, it should not be like this. Let's see how exactly we'll apply our normalization techniques to further improve this data. Okay. Now, this is instead of specifying the data like this, entering the entire data in one sheet, this is a normalized data. Okay. So here you can observe. The same table, the same single table has been distributed across three different tables. One is called employee table, other one is called department table, the last one is called time card table. Okay, now if you see each and every table has a column which is unique in that particular table, and doesn't contain duplicates. The column which is highlighted in a color, blue color there, those are the primary key columns for those corresponding tables. Okay.
Yes.
Now, if you see employee, employee number 10, 100, 700, sorry, 500, 799. So, employee number is repeating only once, and you have corresponding employee name, corresponding employee first name, employee last name, department number. Okay. And the department name is being given in a separate table.
Okay.
And same way, we have time card data. Time card data, mein, we have individual time card numbers. Correspondingly, for each and every time card number, we have an employee number correspondingly. Now, we also have a time card date as well. Okay.
Now, okay.
You have to observe one important thing here. I have employee number, which is primary key column in employee table. Okay. That Got same it. Column, that same column is present, employee number column is present in the time card data also.
Okay.
Okay. Now this is called foreign key column. Okay. A column, any column which is already in primary key column in another table, which is present in another table, then that particular column is called foreign key column. Very, very important. Okay. Now, whenever you are trying to relate tables between multiple, relate a connection between multiple tables, we have to use this primary key column and secondary foreign key column relationship only. Okay. Now, to establish a relationship between your employee table and time card table, there is only one column which is common between two tables, that is employee number column. Okay.
Yes.
Now, when you have a common column between two tables, then only you can establish a connection between those tables. Okay. Now, employee number column, which is a primary key column in employee table, acts as foreign key column in time card table.
Okay.
Understood?
Understood.
Now, foreign key column, if it is a foreign key contain duplicates, can contain duplicates. There is no restriction of unique data. Only primary key column will contain, will adhere to the steps which we already discussed, right? Which is unique and not null. Unique and not null. But a foreign key can contain duplicates. Now, employee number column, which is a primary key column in employee table, is present in time card table as a foreign key column. That's the concept. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Clear?
Clear.
On the same similar lines, department number, you see, department table is there. In that, department number is a primary key column where you see there department numbers are unique, which are 10, 20, and 50. The department numbers is present in the department
employee table.
Department number column in employees table. Now, department number column in employee table is a foreign key column. Okay. Whereas department number in department's table is a primary key. Now you can establish relationship between department's table and employees table because we have a common column called department number.
Okay.
Clear, na? Understood?
Understood.
Yes. So this is a primary concept. If you understand this concept, then only we can proceed with the database, creating tables and all. Because every table will be constructed using only this concept, which is primary key, foreign key concept. Okay. Now, whenever you want to establish two tables, a relationship between two tables, then we need to have a primary key column in one table. And that same column should be present in another column as a foreign key. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Can you please go back to the fourth slide?
Okay.
I'll just see the difference.
Yes, please.
Okay.
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 Here, thing is that
The thing is, sir, there is the employee number or the employee name, the repetition that we have here, okay?
Yes.
Okay, that repetition is not there in fifth column, no? I'm sorry, in fifth slide.
In the second slide, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, the same data we have arranged in this fashion, such that there is no redundancy. I mean, how this is arranged, there are some steps actually. We'll have to follow some steps called normalization steps. Based on the steps, we'll come to this particular result. But this is how we construct table. Using normalization concepts, we will actually convert this table, which is an entire set of redundant data, we are converting into this kind of a data. Now, how it is getting converted, by following what rules we are converting, that we are going to see.
Sir, we made it to three separate data tables, no? One, two, three tables we have made it in the fifth slide, no?
Correct.
So why did we make department separate and time card separate, time card data table separate? So we could have just removed the duplicate from the fourth column, from the fourth slide. It would have been corrected, no? If we remove the duplicates.
Actually, we cannot do that actually, because see, if you see practically, you will understand. Time card data is a different data altogether. Those concepts we will see probably at the end of the session. You will understand why we did that.
So what
are the normalization rules and what it says? You will understand. Then I will come back to your question. We'll see what is types of normalization. See what we have. Three normalization techniques. Normalization. Second normalization, third normalization. Now we'll see these rules, we'll understand these rules, and based on these rules, we'll try to split the data accordingly. First normalization form. What the first normalization form says, each field contains smallest meaningful value. And the table does not contains repeating groups or fields or repeating data within the same field. That's what your first normalization form says. Now, if you see this data, first normalization form, what it says is the table does not contain repeating groups of data within the same field. Now, if you see this data is violating the first normalization form. That means we have some part numbers. P0010, P0020, those are part numbers. And I have some warehouse numbers, warehouse A, warehouse B, warehouse C. But this is not the way we will include data in while constructing your first normalization form. This is not the correct way. It says it is really a bad setup. Because in the same field called warehouse, in the same column called warehouse, we have multiple data separated with a comma. That is what it should avoid. If you go and see the second line, it says the table should not or does not contain repeating data within the same field. Now here we have repeating data within the same same field. Now instead of specifying like this, you can specify the data in this way. Part ID, that is P01020, warehouse A, warehouse B in a separate column, warehouse C in a separate column. So this particular data violates the first normalization form. This is a better way of representing as per first normalization form. Whenever you are asked what is the first normalization form, you should say same field should not contain repetitive set of data. That's the first normalization form. Repeating data within the same field should be avoided. That's what the first normalization form says. Now, table conformed to first normalization form. You see here, you don't contain any, in the same column, you don't have a repetitive set of data. Warehouse A, comma, warehouse B, it's not like that. We could separate it into separate records. Now P0010, P0010, it is repeating here. This table is not adhering to all the normalization forms, but this is somehow adhering to first normalization form. Basically, if you adhere to all the normalization forms, then we'll be able to construct a proper table. Okay, but we'll see one by one what is first normalization form says and how that is implemented. Okay, so instead of specifying warehouse A, B, C in a same column, what we are doing it here, we are specifying it in the different rows.
Okay.
You understood, no? What first normalization form says, avoid repeating same data in same column. Okay. That's first normalization form.
First normalization form, it says. Okay. So, but this first normalization rule does not say that the primary key should not repeat like that. This will not say, but it will say the column should not contain the repetitive
set of data. That's what first normalization form says. Correct.
Okay.
Now we will move on to the next normalization form, which is second normalization form. Okay. Second normalization form usually used in tables with multiple field primary composite key. Okay. Each non-key field relates to the entire primary key, and it says any field that does not relate to the primary key is placed in a separate table. Okay. Now you can relate to your first question. Any field that does not relate to the primary key is placed in a separate table. That's why in your, I'm going back to the fifth slide. Okay. You asked me one question now, why this time card details is separated in a separate table, because time card data is not dependent on employee number. Okay. It is dependent on time card number. Okay. So any information which is not directly depending on the primary key should be separated into a separate table. That's what second normalization form says. Okay. Now, if you see the previous slide, which is fourth slide, here you have some information called time card date as well as time card number. Okay. Yes. Your time card details depends on time card number, not on employee number. Correct?
Okay. Employee name depends on employee number. Correct? No?
Sorry?
Employee name.
Yes.
Depends on employee number.
Employee name depends on employee number. Department number also to some extent depends on employee number, but time card number generally doesn't, time card, at least time card date doesn't depend on time card number. So that is why we can split this time card information to a separate table. Also, department name doesn't depend on employee ID. Department name depends on department number. Correct, no? Yes. So correct. Marketing department name depends on department number, not on employee number. So again, correct. Department information can be split into another table. Now you understood, no? Why it split into multiple tables? As per second normalization form, it says that any information which is not directly dependent on primary key should be separated into a different table. That's what second normalization form says. I'll go to that slide. Second normalization form. You see here, any field that does not relate to the primary key is placed in a separate table. You should remember this. This is what second normalization form says. Okay. So that is when these points come into picture. Eliminate redundant data in a table and create separate tables for set of values that applies to multiple records. Okay. Now, again, I'm going back to that previous fourth slide example. Here, marketing is repeating, marketing. It's repeating multiple times. Even time card date also repeats multiple times. I want to avoid that repetition. That's why if you go and create a table like this, here marketing is not repeating, accounting is not repeating, even your time card date is not repeating. So like that, you can avoid repetition of data again and again by adhering to the second normalization form. Okay. So your second normalization form says, whichever data does not depend on primary key, just split it accordingly into a multiple table. And it also says eliminate redundant data. That means repetition of data should be avoided. To whichever extent you can avoid, you can avoid that. In some cases, there will be a repetition. We can't avoid that. But if at all, if you can avoid it by creating a separate table, please do that. That's what second normalization form says. Okay. Now you see here, one example which violates second normalization form. Okay, here you see primary keys repeating, warehouse number A, warehouse A, B, warehouse B is getting repeated, warehouse C, D is there, but warehouse B is getting repeated. Okay, yes. Quantity is there, warehouse address is there. Now, how can we adhere to normalization form? I can create a separate table for called warehouse table and include that table there. So I go to that. Here you see warehouse is a different table. Stock ID is a different table. Okay, now here I am separating all the warehouse related information separately. Here you see warehouse information is not repeating and address is also not repeating. Here address probably can repeat or whatever it is. You can see 4141 Greenway Drive is repeating. Here also warehouse is repeating. Now whatever that information which is redundant, which is repeating, I can avoid that and I keep it in a separate table. Okay, that's why I'm keeping in a separate table. You might ask me one question. As you are keeping warehouse information in separate table, why we need warehouse information here as well, correct?
Yeah, because we are keeping only one B here.
No, actual idea behind keeping warehouse column here, because we need to establish a relationship between these two tables, no?
Correct.
Whenever we try establishing relationship between two tables, we need a common column, correct?
Yes.
For that purpose, we are keeping this warehouse information. Now, this warehouse is a foreign key in your stock table, okay? And your this is primary key in your warehouse table. In warehouse table, warehouse information, warehouse A, B, C, D. This is not repeating, correct? Now, this is a primary key here. This is a foreign key here.
Okay.
Now, actually, I should edit that. It is not primary key here. It is foreign key.
Foreign key.
Okay. In this table, this is foreign key. In this table, it is primary key. Okay. So just to establish relationship between these two tables, I've kept warehouse information in my stock table also. And the address, whatever it is coming to the secondary table. Understood, na? Clear with the concept?
Clear, sir.
Yes. So that is a table adhering to second normalization form. So what is your first normalization form says? One column should not contain repetitive set of data. That is comma, comma, warehouse A, comma, warehouse B, comma, warehouse. That should not happen. So that is first normalization. Second normalization says you should not contain redundant set of information in one particular table. Here we are having redundant information in our previous table, which is getting repeated again and again. And also we have warehouse address is not dependent on part ID, correct? Warehouse yes. Address is dependent on warehouse number, not on part ID. So we are splitting the these two columns into a separate table. That's what second normalization form says.
But this quantity related to part, right?
Quantity is also related to warehouse. But I have warehouse information here also, no? Warehouse A, warehouse B. Warehouse B, even though for part 010, it is quantity is 400. Okay. Warehouse B, part 020, it is 200. Okay. This quantity is not only dependent on warehouse, it is also dependent on part.
Okay.
You're understanding, na? If you are keeping this quantity in this particular, in the second table, you're not sure where 400 comes, you're not sure where 200 comes, because there are two information, na? One information for part number 10, other information for part number 20. There are two different informations. So your quantity should come in the first table, not come in the second table.
Okay.
Clear?
Clear.
Yes. So we have to clearly understand which column is dependent on which. Now your quantity is depending on warehouse as well as part. So it has to come in the stock table. It should not come in the warehouse table.
Okay.
So that's about second normalization form. Now we'll see the final thing, which is third normalization form. Okay.
Okay.
So usually used in tables with single field primary key, that's fine. Record does not depend on anything other than a table's primary key. Each non-key field is a fact about the key. So it says value in a record that are not part of the record's key does not belong to the table. In general, any time the contents of a group of the fields may apply to more than a single record in the table. Okay, so it again emphasizes on the same thing. Whichever fields which are not dependent on the primary key column should come to the another table. That's what it says. Each non-key field is that does not depend on anything other than table's primary key. It says if you have any columns in a particular table, that should go and primarily it should depend on the primary key. Okay, if you have one column which does not depend on that, that column should not present in the particular table. That's what third normalization form says. Okay, so you see here, this is a table which is violating the third normalization form. Okay, now I have employee number, I have first name, last name, department and department name. Okay, now your department name does not dependent on the employee
number. It depends on the work department.
Correct, work department. So this table should not be present in the first table. That's what it says. So if you go and see the second table, it says the work department name will entirely come in the second table. Now, that's what third normalization form says. Even though you don't have any redundant data, department name, even though it doesn't contain redundant data, it has to depend on primary key column. Then only that column should present in the first table. Otherwise, split it into the second table. Okay. Now your
we will split into the second table. But the thing is, the department name is repeating here.
Department is repeating here. That is, it is not even adhering to the second normalization form also.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is why we are splitting it into a separate table and making it unique. Now operations is not repeating now. So software support. There are only two departments, which is directly depending on the. So third normalization form, what it actually says is, whatever columns you have present in a table should directly dependent on the primary key in that particular table. That's what the third normalization form says. Okay. Second normalization form emphasizes on the redundant data. If anything is repeating, any column, any row data is repeating again and again, please put it in a separate table. Third normalization form says there should not be any column which is non-dependent on the primary key column. Now, first name is dependent on the employee number. Last name is also dependent on the employee number. Work department also depend on the employee number. So these three columns are dependent on the employee number. So we keep that. But department name is something which is not dependent on the department number. So we are splitting into a different table, and we are to establish the relationship between these two tables, I'm keeping the work department also in the employee table. Clear, no?
Work department.
Sorry?
Sir, the last thing you said. Sir,
your voice is not audible.
Sir, work department, sir. Work department, where you are keeping in the first table, sir?
That's what you see the arrow mark there. You can see the arrow mark here, no?
Yes.
So always remember, as I mentioned, when you are creating a relational database, you are creating it to establish relationships between two tables. Okay. Whenever you want to establish relationship between two tables, there should be a common column between two tables. Okay. Now, if you want to relate two tables, which is employee table and department table, there should be one column which is common between two tables to establish a relationship. Okay. Now, for some reason, you want to understand, let's say, which department John is working. I want, whether it is operations department or software support department, you want to establish or you want to extract that report. Okay. Yes. In that case, what we want to do, we want to establish a relationship between employee table and department table, correct?
Yes, sir.
So to establish a relationship, what we want a common column, which is department number is a primary key column in this department table, that we need a foreign key relationship. This is a foreign key column in your employee table, such that you can establish a relationship. Always remember that. Okay, there should be some column to establish a relationship. Otherwise, you can't merge two tables. You can't join two tables without a primary key, foreign key relationship. For that purpose, we are keeping department number in the employee table also.
Okay, sir.
Clear?
Clear.
Yes. So these are the three normalization forms. Very, very important concept actually. Three normalization. Just go through these three concepts once again. Okay. Sure, so probably I'll share this PPT with you. You can go through this PPT. There are multiple examples. You can just go through and understand how normalization forms are being created. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
What about your system? It is getting ready or how it is?
Sir, tomorrow I will take this to the service center.
Okay, tomorrow. Okay, take it to that. Service centers are working in the lockdown?
No, they're not working. I will take it to his home.
Okay.
From home, he will install Windows 7 I'm running with. He said that might be the reason. I will update Windows 10.
Okay, fine. That is fine. Windows 10 would help because in Windows 10, there is no additional drivers which is required. In Windows 7 and all, we need additional audio drivers.
Yeah.
Probably that might be the issue. You can upgrade your OS. Yeah, that would be the solution, I guess.
Yes.
Tomorrow. Okay, so try upgrading it. Okay. Tomorrow there won't be class. Because we will start with the actual creating tables and all that. So we'll start from Monday. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Once we are clear with this, just go through all the concepts once again. From Monday, we'll start. I'll show you the tool. What is the tool and what are types of the queries? And we'll start creating a small database and all that.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So get it resolved meanwhile. Okay. Sure, so we'll meet again on Monday. Okay.
Sure, sir.
Okay.